back on Irish Football Fan TV now here with a few fans outside before the game. What's your belief here?
I'm for the team, I'm going to go 1-0. I think they're playing well, they're confident. Just get a result. Thank God.
What do you think?
Same 1-0, apparently all the Austrians are getting married, so...
Apparently one of them anyway. There's no fullbacks because of it. But what do you think?
I'm going to go for 3-1 because we never scored 3 goals.
Okay.
But, so I'm feeling very optimistic. Absolutely. I think Austria are, their heads are down. Yeah. I think, as I said, if your players can't be arsed to turn up to when you get married, you're not in a good place. I think we've got this. This is the bag.
Okay. Finally.
One each, I think. I think Alaba's going to score. He always scores against us.
One each. He fucking said one.
I know it did, but I'm all about it since then.
Stop thinking about it.
Well, lads, enjoy the game. Yeah. And cheers. Might see you again afterwards. But have a good time. Hope you all.
We're here with the Austria fans, and they're going to give us their predictions of the game. How do you think it's going to go?
I think there will be two red cards for the Irish people, because the Irish ones are really hard ones. I like the Irish soccer playing, but it's definitely, well, what we say, it's not a soccer playing, it's just a foot rugby.
I'm Rapid Vienna supporter. I don't want to talk about Austria tonight. Yes. I'm Rapid Vienna supporter, you know. But we will lose. We will lose.
Okay, what do you think the score is going to be? The final score?
I think it will
1-3.
I think
for
it will be...
For Austria.
For Austria, and you?
I think it's 0-2 for Irish.
Okay. There you have 2-0 Ireland and...
3-1 for Ireland.
3-1 to Austria. Ireland or Austria?
Ireland.
Okay. There you have it. The Austrians are predicting that Ireland are going
to
win.
I don't want to be beaten up after the game, so I hope that Ireland will win.
Well, there you go, lads.
That's right.
Thanks very much, guys.
Well, welcome back to Irish Football Fan TV. We're here with a couple of fans getting a reaction from the Austria game, a 1-1 draw here at the Aviva Stadium. Lads, what do you think of the game?
Pretty sweet. Poor performance until the last sort of 10 minutes. We kind of picked it up a bit, but... bad for 80 minutes really.
Yeah. And going on for the 80 minutes or so, Austria didn't actually cause us a lot of problems. We didn't create a lot of chances ourselves.
We've got to beat them. We've got to beat them. Yeah. Austria were poor as well. Austria were very poor as well.
We've been speaking since the game finished, and a lot of criticism for. And between me and myself and Paul, we're both Glenn Whelan fans, but it was a very poor game today.
Yeah.
What did you feel on the Glenn Whelan performance, and if we should have played Wes Houlihan instead of him?
The fact he came off after, didn't finish the game, sits at all. You know, Glenn Whelan normally finishes any match.
Yeah.
But he just wasn't in the game today. None of them were. They all wanted to go on holidays.
Yeah. All of the midfielders, they just weren't in the game. Even though I think that Whelan's probably the best of the three midfielders today.
Yeah.
But, none of them could get a real handle on the game. You know, we just couldn't control
them. None of them today.
Yeah.
And obviously, Jeff Hendrick was put on the right side of our midfield to... contend with David Alaba, who's playing on the left end, which Bayern Munich central midfield, a lot of talent about him.
It's a tough match.
How do you think that Hendrick kind of did in the game as such?
He done what Jeff Hendrick does, and he does his best.
Yeah, he was never really in it, was he? You know, you could have forgotten that he played, really. You could have forgot that he played. He tries his hardest, but
it's not good enough.
He just can't put a stamp
on the game. He's good
for
Burnley, but
he just can't put a stamp on the game for Ireland.
And speaking of Burnley, Kevin Long, 90 minutes at centre half for Ireland in a competitive game. How do you feel he did?
Man of the match.
Done a great job,
Best player
in the game.
Best player on the pitch.
And then John Walters' goal, it's a cracking finish, isn't it?
Yeah. But
we wanted to see more of the same, didn't we? Throughout the game. Yeah. It was
the last 10 minutes when it looked like the whole game.
Yeah. Last 10 minutes, the crowd really got behind the lads there, and we sort of picked it up. But it was a great finish right in the bottom corner, can't complain.
And then prospects, rest of qualifying, obviously as we speak, Wales and Serbia are playing on the TV in the corner there. What do we want result wise from that, and what do we want the rest of the qualifying campaign?
I want, I suppose, 1-1, might be the best for Ireland. We all want that three harsh race, I suppose, at the end of the day. Keep ourselves in Serbia. Serbia get a few injuries.
Yeah.
Hopefully
Serbia come to Dublin in September.
That's a must win. That's a must win in September. We have to beat them, really, if you want to go automatically to Russia, have to beat them.
Do we think we'll qualify? Then between the whether we get there automatically or whether we get there through a playoff, yeah, think we're in Russia next summer.
I think stumble into it.
It's never easy. It's never easy. But yeah.
Well, they won't qualify automatically to get there through a playoff.
Yeah, it's never. Yeah, we never make it easy. But yeah, I think we'll be in Russia this time. This time next year.
Perfect. Thank you very much, guys.
No problem. Fans
enjoyed the game. Hopefully we'll speak after the Serbia game or whatever later in the year.
Right, thanks for having us. Thanks very much.
There was some of the fans here at the Wellington Pub here. How do you think the game went?
Draw wasn't a bad result. You know, like,
sorry?
Draw wasn't a bad result.
You would have taken a win before the game, though, would you?
Yeah.
Oh, surely. Well, it should have been a win.
With the man that were missing, I'd say probably a draw was a good result. Obviously, Austria are missing a few men themselves, like, but I'd say probably with Ireland missing the likes of Shane Long and the boys.
Coleman.
Yeah, obviously Coleman, but we had a good result today. Yes, things didn't go our way with the referee being a wee bit bad or whatever it was. And the goal that was disallowed or whatever it was. But we had a good day, and I'd say a fair result. A fair play to the Austrian boys for coming over, and they looking down at their supporters, they looked like they had a good old day in Dublin.
Yeah, and as far as like the chances, like we did look like, you know, we were unlucky, like two clearances off the line, and then obviously the goal being disallowed as well. But as far as the players, I mean, to me it kind of looked like it's kind of the end of the line for Glenn Whelan a bit.
I think it was sort of the end of the lane, to be honest with you, man. The likes of Walters and stuff, like he was feeding off scraps, but the ball was getting hit in the places that he didn't want to run. Like if Shane Long was playing and the ball was getting hit in them places, he would go there and he would feed off them scraps. But Walters is just, what you're saying is maybe he probably wouldn't run on them sort of paints.
I was saying Whelan, Glenn Whelan.
Whelan's doing alright in the minute. He's scrapping away, man. He's doing alright. And I don't think he'll have to stay down. I think he'll be still scrapping away the way Whelan always plays his game. You know what I mean, man?
I thought you just liked a bit of energy. That's what I feel.
Who are you going to have?
Yeah, normally if McCarthy was fit, I'd have him in there, obviously.
If McCarthy was fit, but you're not going to get the energy from Whelan, as you say. Yes, he's getting on in the years or whatever it is, but obviously McCarthy, but Whelan's not a bad fellow. Like,
yeah, no, he's been a great servant. I mean, I just think his age is catching up on him a bit now, that's all I mean.
Oh, well, sure, I mean, if Roy Keane, who's a legend, and Martin O'Neill, who's a legend, see him fit to play in midfield, I mean, they see something that we don't see. We're not playing, you know?
And as far as the...
Yeah, lads, obviously due to the accent, bunch of naughty lads drinking around here, James McLean and Shane Duffy, how do you feel the two of them got on today, on the left wing and the centre half?
Oh, but even at that early,
McLean.
The biggest disappointment I thought today was the referee. I'm not a bit bad, but I thought he'd give us absolutely nothing.
Oh, but even at that, James McLean had a steady game. Like, he didn't show too much in the first half, but in the second half he started to show we bit more of his colours.
I thought Christine made the goal. The time he went up for the tackle.
He did. That's what he said in the second half when he tried to play a wee bit more. You know what I mean?
Yeah. Okay.
He did, surely.
And as far as the group,
I still think we're missing a bit of quality.
Yeah, especially in the midfield. There's no creativity really there.
Yeah.
I mean, Arthur and Henry.
You should have brought Houlihan on earlier.
Yeah, everybody said that.
100%. Yeah, I think you made a bit of a difference when he came on.
Yeah, 100%.
And as far as the group goes, boys, you think we're going to get out of it now?
Well, I hope we'll get the Black North in the...
I think
that was a good result for Ireland, and I think maybe we'll push on from there whenever the Premiership actually starts back and people start getting a wee bit more fitter. Obviously at the end of the season there's a lot of guys who playing all season long and for various different teams.
We're from the Black North.
Whenever it starts back into September and the next matches come on, I'd say Ireland are sort of they pick up a wee bit more momentum against the likes of Austria and stuff, going away to Austria, whatever.
they'll have a good result.
I think Georgia is going to be a big, big.
All right, guys. Thanks very much. Thanks for your time.
Thank you.